Welcome back. I'm now being joined by Aruna Kebira from Global View Capital Limited. Aruna, you are welcome.
Thank you for having me.
As at the time we started this program this afternoon, the Usher Index of the Nigerian Stock Exchange was around 0.10% down. But the market is improving, 0.05%, right? So you have always said that when the market gains on Monday, it's a bad omen.
No, it's a good omen.
Okay, it's a good omen. Mm-hmm. All right. Because the market was up Monday of last week. And the Usher Index was up last week. All right. That means you are correct. Okay. So today, with what we have seen so far, are you expecting the market to see what off this 0.05? And looking at all other indicators, particularly NSC pension, is down 0.04. NSC premium, 0.19% up. All right. Are you expecting the market to still wipe off this 0.05% and close probably marginally up?
No, like what I saw before joining you, I discovered that a lot of stock are looking up because the bids are getting a little bit stronger. I think this is because people are taking position in lieu of the release of quarter three. I think by this week, we're supposed to be seeing early flyers releasing their result to the flow of the Nigeria stock exchange.
Probably from today is 15, probably from after the close of trading on Wednesday till Friday, we expect to see some of those results. But if you look at some of the major gainers as we speak, so far so good today, aside from flour mills that I can see and probably Champion Breweries, all the others are those I could term as Lilliputians. Mansard Insurance, First Aluminium, National Salt, MPF Microfinance, Livestock Feeds, Union Diagnostics.
You know, it is said in my area that it is when men are not around that Lilliputian will come out and be flexing models. I think because of the lull in the market, that is why we are seeing those ones are the best gainers.
All right. Aruna, we are going to converge this Saturday, and this is to formally invite everyone. This Saturday, 10 o'clock in the morning, we are going to be converging in what we call Business Investment and Leadership Academy. We are going to be talking about PEG ratio, the one I've been talking about, how I arrived at those projections I'm going to be teaching you. The only thing everything I know, I want the public also to know. Back in days, in this market, we are about the only organizations that we even endeavor to calculate earnings ourselves because information was scanty and scarce. But now earnings are all over the places. We continued, we will teach you. Aruna would also be there. So those numbers that you can see on the screen, you call now for details and the location and some other basic information that you might be needing. Now back to the studio. Aruna, what are you going to be telling us this Saturday?
I think the first thing I want to tell the people is those things that the broker sees that they have not been seeing. At least we want to give them the opportunity so that they will see exactly what the broker is seeing while trading.
All right.
Then secondly, we want to look at the market before the quarter three earnings releases and the market after the quarter three earnings releases. I want to also look at the market before primaries and the market after primaries.
Aruna, are you going to be bringing your companies, is it OMS now, so that you teach us the best way to make use of that platform?
That's exactly what I'm going to do. But unfortunately, the market will not be on.
Yes, the market does not need to be on. All I just want is a situation whereby you bring it, you open it, and then you show us, because the platform is going to be on.
Yes.
So the idea is that back in days, until you give information to your brokers, and sometimes some fraudulent stockbrokers, then it is not all stockbrokers, will collect your information and collect your money, buy the stocks for themselves, and tell you it is not available. And then much later, when the price will have been up, they will now sell to you just You know, but now you don't need to even call a broker.
The present management of Nigeria Stock Exchange have wiped out that off.
Right.
They have made the market so transparent that you cannot do what you have just said. It cannot be done again.
All right, Aruna, some of those equities that we see, Lilliputians, do I go and put my money there and I just, or I hold on? What strategy do you think?
No, last question. Always said that you look for equities that are fundamentally sound because they will never disappoint you, whether in bear season, whether in bull season. So as far if you take position with a fundamentally sound stock, you cannot lose it. Even when it is down for now, you know, probably the moment the market gets back, it is up.
Right. I don't know. You see the man there waving his hand like that is telling us that we got to round off. All right. We've got to go. But your number?
Yeah. My number is 002-300-9379. 002-300-9379.
All right. Thank you so much, Aruna.
Thank you.
Next Monday, we hope to be with you. But before Monday, on Sunday, this is how we round off on this platform.